I mean, we all know what happened with this whole Zoomicron fiasco, Zoomicron Gate, as it's being termed online, right? You know, if I was the campaign strategist of the opposition, I would really, really, I would really leverage on this, because at this stage in the campaign, especially now that face-to-face or mask-to-mask muscle flexing traditional activities like motorcades and rallies have again been shelved. We're back to, you know, the online realm.
Yeah.
Once again, we are back to the online realm. If I was the opponent of if I were the other presidential candidates against Marcos Jr., I would leverage greatly on this, because now is the time to start eating soft votes, what you call soft votes.
Before we run out of time, I want to talk about the other candidates as well. We just showed a clip of Manila Mayor Isko Moreno there, and also Senator Ping Lacson. We got to talk about Manny Pacquiao as well. I mean, what is happening to their campaigns? What's going on with Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, for example? Lots of people saying he's losing steam. What do you think?
Well, he will definitely get a shot in the arm if this ESA thing takes off. I don't know if you've seen ESA, but there's a lot of talk and rumblings about this Magkaisa ISSA, which is Isko Sara. It's being floated around that PRRD, President Duterte, will in fact endorse him. So that's being floated around. If that happens, then definitely that campaign will gain a lot of steam. He's come out with new ad material lately. So the thing about Mayor Isko is they are, I believe, I'm obviously not part of that campaign team, but if you look at it mathematically, they are holding on to their position that Mayor Isko is everybody's second choice. Now, if you analyze that statement, there is a lot of truth in that. If you ask the diehard supporters of the other candidates who their second choice is, it will predominantly always be Mayor Isko. Mm-hmm. So what they're trying to do right now, I mean, or at least what I would try to do if I was on that team, is to really convert the soft votes into the second choice votes. So that's what's happening to that campaign. Now, as far as Senator Ping is concerned, he's been doing his press rounds. He's been condemning activities that he feels that his other rival candidates have been doing or not been doing. Senator Manny, I have not heard much from him. The thing is, I think that campaign really needs to repivot, because they were greatly leveraged on gatherings, on interactions wherein he would appear before the public and make a speech and give things away, right? Give stuff away, essentially.
But that's been choked because of the pandemic.
Exactly. So perhaps they need to repivot and really study what their above the line and below the line communications, integrated marketing communications.
I want to go back to the idea that you brought up a while ago, a possibility of Manila Mayor Isko Moreno and Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte joining forces. That is at play. What would make sense now? What would make more sense for the HQ of Vice President Leni Robredo? Should she go for Manny? Should she go for Senator Ping? But then where does that leave Senator Tito Soto, who's also enjoying good numbers?
When you say go for, do you mean should she adopt them, or should she?
Yeah, if talks of unifying, if that's still at play, is that something that the vice president and the other contenders should also look to?
Well, the last time I guessed it on your show, unfortunately, I absolutely swung and missed, because I did make the prediction that Mayor Inday would go for the presidency, and we all know what happened there, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I will make a similar prediction now, and let's see if I'll swing and miss. At this point, I don't think there will be any breakups in the VP Leni Senator Kiko coalition, because I think it would be terribly off-brand. And if she did go for another vice presidential candidate, it would be terribly off-brand, because from the start, her campaign has always been, I'm not about opportunistic politics. I'm not about choosing the convenient choice, but the best choice.
But she would also be saying that she's still she's for unity, right? That
yes.
she's all about consolidating the opposition.
Consolidation is the perfect word. I think she's more of everybody bandying together against a common opponent, not necessarily splitting up the tandems and having a mixed match. But again, last time I guessed it, I swung big and I missed big, so who knows?
You know, if I didn't know you, I would say that, you know, you might just be throwing out a strategy there without, you know, like a strategic point there that you're just saying, hopeful that that message would stick. I don't know who your intended recipient is, but I don't know, because it's you, Alan, that I'm talking to. Maybe you're just saying maybe you'll miss, but you're actually saying that you won't. I don't know. You're a strategist.
It's a curious profession I'm in, indeed. And well, you know, at the end of the day, we just hope that the elections will truly reflect the will of the people, and that they're peaceful and orderly, and that there will be an election, right? Because there's also talk that there might not be.
Yeah, well, the COMELEC said the vote will push through, and we're going to have to trust the COMELEC on that. We've run out of time, Alan, but thank you again for joining us today. We really appreciate it. Till the next prediction, maybe, in a few months' time. By the way, last question. Everybody's saying at this point it's too early. You know, wherever they stand at this point, it's too early. But tell us, when should they stick to this line until it's really too late for them?
In terms of the numbers and catching up, I would say second week of March would be a good indicator. That's already statistically weighty enough to have we call it an econometric line. Sorry for the term, but yeah, an OLS line.
All right. Thanks again, Alan Herman there, veteran campaign strategist, joining us on the program. Appreciate it. Happy New Year to you. Take care and you keep safe.
Thank you so much. Always a pleasure. Everybody keep safe. Mabuhay po ang Pilipinas. Thanks.